Hit the red subscribe button and press the bell icon to never miss another update from Techetarian. Hello friends, this is Harsh Trivedi from Techetarian, and in this video I am going to show you how to create a persistent storage in your bootable Kali Linux USB. So if you haven't watched the previous video, then make sure you watch that first by simply clicking on the I button popping right now from the top right corner of your device. We will start our video with the definition of persistence according to Bootable USB. So persistence is a space on your USB storage device that can be used to store data so that the data is still there after a reboot. That means you can carry a full-fledged customized operating system in your cute and compact USB. So now let's start off with the process, but first of all you'll need a USB storage device that can store our operating system and other data too. So I'll be using a 16GB SanDisk CruiserBlade USB for this video. You can use a microSD card too, but I prefer a pen drive over a microSD card. After that, you'll need a software for creating a partition that supports Linux file system, so that we can do some additional setup in our Kali Linux USB, which will help us in creating a persistent configuration file later. So simply download Mini Tool Partition Wizard from the link down below in the description, or visit www.partitionwizard.com/download.html and simply choose the local download link under the free edition label. You can also download the professional edition or the server edition, but for now we don't need that because the free edition is powerful enough to create a persistent storage for your bootable Kali Linux USB. So to save some time, I already have installed Mini Tool Partition Wizard. So let's start it up and allow the UAC prompt by clicking on the yes button. And after that, launch the main application. I'm using an older version, so let's ignore this update. It won't prompt you as you will be using the latest version of this software. Okay, so now as you can see that I've already connected a 16GB pen drive to my PC. This is the same pen drive which I used in the previous video to create a bootable Kali Linux USB, and this is the same reason that the pen drive already contains a Kali Linux OS. So now we'll create a persistent storage in this pen drive, and for that simply right click on your USB drive letter and choose the move forward slash resize option and drag these small arrows to choose what size of partition you want, or you can simply type out the exact size in the partition size text field. In my case, I'll simply type out 5.0, so it'll leave 9.6 gigs for us to create a persistent partition, and click on the OK button. And now you'll see that an unallocated storage is visible right beside the storage filled up with your Kali Linux operating system. So we'll use this partition to create persistence in Kali Linux, and for that, right click on the unallocated partition and click on the create option. And after that, it'll prompt you about Windows not being able to see the second partition in the USB. So we'll just click on the yes button to agree with the dialog box. Now type out persistence in the partition label text field and make sure to choose primary in the create as drop-down menu and ext4 in the file system drop-down menu, because ext is the file system which was specifically created for Linux kernel, and just for our persistent USB need, it will be the best choice. Oops, so I have to type the partition label again. No problem. Now click on the OK button and click on the apply button. And after that, wait for Mini Tool Partition Wizard to do its work. But wait till the time process is being completed. Hit that red subscribe button and be a part of Techetarian family. Okay, so now when everything is done, we'll close the tool and ignore the format disk warning by clicking on the cancel button. And after following all those easy to understand steps, we'll restart our PC and boot it up from the USB by holding down the hotkey. And after that, when you are prompted with Kali Linux Grand Boot Loader, choose the Live USB Persistence option, and after doing that, Just wait for Kali Linux to boot up properly. Okay, so now as we can see that a persistent storage has appeared on our Kali Linux desktop, and that means we have successfully created a persistent partition. So now open up the terminal and type out the first command, that is fdisk space hyphen l, and press enter. It will show all the information about all the storage devices that are connected to your PC. Now here we have to note down our ext4 partition's device path. For me it is /dev/sdb2, but it can vary from system to system. So to check that if we are choosing the correct partition or not, simply notice that if Linux is written under its type label or not. Okay, so now when you know your persistent partition's path, we can type out our second command, and that is mkdir space hyphen p space /mnt/anyname, and by any name I mean to say that you can type any name. For example, it can be your name, your PC's brand name or whatnot, because it's just a directory that we created using mkdir command. But make sure it is something easy to remember. For this tutorial, I'll simply use my name and press enter. And now you have to mount the persistent partition, so simply type out the third command, and that is mount /dev/sdb2/mnt/anyname, and this time you have to type out the same name that you used to create that directory instead of any name. So in my case, I'll simply type out my name again, because that's what I used in the previous command to create that directory, and press enter. And now comes a creatively big command, which will help us in creating a persistent configuration file, so simply type out the fourth command, and that is echo /union/mnt/anyname/persistence.conf. And yeah, you have to use the same name you used in the place of any name while creating that directory, so I'll use my name here, which I used to create that directory, and press enter. And now you have to unmount your persistent partition, so simply type out our fifth command, and that is umount /dev/sdb2. Where your persistent partition device path may vary from system to system, and after typing all that, press enter, and then you can leave the terminal by typing out our last command, and that is exit. Now what you have to do is simply restart your PC and again boot it up using your bootable Kali Linux USB using the live USB persistence option. Okay, so now as you can see that the persistent partition is not visible to us on our Kali Linux desktop. So let us test that if the live USB persistence works or not. So to test the persistent storage, I'll quickly create a folder named as test and also change the desktop background just to make everything look different from the default Kali Linux which we are using right now. And after that, I'll simply reboot my PC. And once again, I'll boot it up from the 16GB USB storage device and choose the live USB persistence option from the Kali Linux boot menu. And as you can see that our desktop background is the same that we chose before rebooting the PC, and that folder name test is also here. So that means we have successfully created a persistent partition in our bootable Kali Linux USB. So that's it for this video. Don't forget to hit the like button if you learned something new. share this video with your friends and family, and if you haven't already, then make sure to hit the red subscribe button.